Welcome to the beautiful sewage works of Baldock. What a lovely location. But I tell you, the smell is not half as bad as it was in the early 1800s, where there was no sewage system here at all.
And before the 1870s, sewage came through this area in drains and open channels into cesspools, sometimes only a few yards from wells where drinking water was drawn. Imagine the smell, especially in this time period when people believed the smell or miasma itself carried disease. It was also an area prone to flooding and was known as Hell End because of the awful living conditions people endured. As the whole country was becoming more industrialised in the 1800s, the population of Baldock was multiplying fast, but the majority of people were still living crammed into the same medieval town area.
The area here became the slums of Baldock.
The local authority played no part in housing, and badly built houses sprang up in more and more crowded conditions, often with more than one family in a single house and only one pump of water for a whole street. Doctors warned that the local government needed to take action to prevent disease outbreaks, including typhoid, which was spread by the drinking water supply.
All across the country, rivers and wells polluted with sewage were spreading disease
and killing thousands. In London, the cholera outbreak of 1853-4 claimed over 10,000 lives, as 2.5 million people's sewage simply drained through the streets straight into the river.
The past 50 years had seen a group of new technologies like steam trains and steam trips and even lawnmowers. But the system of sewage was still behind, and dangerously so. The Great Stink of 1858 caused the upper classes to hold handkerchiefs to their noses and complain of the feculence and smell of the river. But it also struck fear of death and disease.
Because of this, a new sewage system was constructed by the 1870s, which prevented any future cholera outbreaks.
Okay, one little quiz question. True or false, it is still completely legal for water companies to dump untreated sewage straight into our rivers.
It's true. This is because the vast majority of our current sewer system is still set up in the same way as these Victorian sewers, in a combined sewage system. Both dirty sewage water and rainwater go down the same pipes, mixed together, and are treated in the same way. When there are storms, too much rainwater floods the sewage system, so it's released raw and untreated straight into rivers. There are over 17,000 sites in England and Wales where it's completely legal to dump this untreated sewage. In 2022, there were over 100 sewage spills a day, containing harmful bacteria like E. coli at amounts thousands of times higher than improperly treated sewage, quantities unsafe for people. On top of this, most of the buildings and pipes themselves were installed over 50 years ago, so were old and breaking.
I can't believe you're all still doing this!
We need to build new systems, where rainwater can be absorbed into the ground or reused, instead of overflowing the sewage system. We need to invest in replacing and repairing broken and old systems, like the one at Ivel Springs, which often leaks. In the Ivel catchment, water companies are more damaging than any other factor. And in this country, 0% of our rivers are in good chemical health.
The Victorians took national pride in their sewers, which is something you can't do today. They invested vast sums in innovative technologies and saved thousands of lives, and even made their sewage treatment works look like palaces.
We have new technologies today that are better than their systems, but we need the Victorians' enthusiasm for change and ingenuity. Locally, we're also lucky enough to be looking after some of the most globally rare habitats, chalk streams. There are only around 200 in the world, and they're uniquely clear and clean, offering a home to species from fish to kingfishers and birds and thousands of weird and wonderful insects. This means it's crucial that we protect these rare habitats from pollution and the effects of taking too much drinking water from here instead of other places. By taking so much water before it can reach the river, the sewage is more concentrated and causes even more damage.
So as my sixth form EPQ project, I'm making this set of three different videos to talk about streams and history in three locations in Baldock, Ashwell and Hitchin. You can check out the other videos over here, and in the description I've also got a map so you can see all the different locations. I've also got all my sources there in case you don't think I'm actually a time traveller.